everybody, welcome back for another episode of Let's Play Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door. In the last episode, we did the interludes and stuff. So in this episode, we're gonna hold up the map to the thousand, or I should say the Crystal Star, to the Thousand Year Door, so that we may know where we will go next. Alright, so that is the fourth Crystal Star that's found. And... oh, mystical map of the Crystal Stars, where is our next location? Let's see here. Alrighty. So, the next location is... down there, I guess, on that little island. Interesting. And it is the Sapphire Star, I guess you could call it. Yeah, I'm not sure if you guys noticed, but each Crystal Star is, like, actually designed after an actual, like, diamond. Or, not an actual diamond, I should say, an actual gem. Quick, let's cruise up to the prof's office. We have to tell that guy about the princess's email.
Oh, yeah.
And... transitioning! Awesome. Let's see here. What? That was written in Princess Peach's email? The legendary treasure is actually the spirit of an ancient demon. And those fiends want to use the power of the Crystal Stars to resurrect it? How bone-chilling. Sadly, it does seem to be consistent with what I've uncovered. Well, come on, give it up, Prof. What did you find out? Huh. This is rather long, so you'd best listen well. Are all of you ready? And you there, in front of the TV, you listen up too. Well, in this case, in front of the computer monitor, you listen up too. Did someone pile drive your head or something? I don't see any computer screen here, nut job. Oh, never you mind, let's say. Don't worry about such trivial details, just listen. The great cataclysm that I read about in the book may well refer to this demon. Oh my god, it's Deathwing! It says that a monster destroyed a large town that stood in this very area. And that sucked. According to NCS, of course. It also says that the seven Crystal Stars were actually created by this monster. And that this thing used the power of the Crystal Stars to control the world. According to this book, the demon was defeated in the end by four heroes. But only the beast's physical form was destroyed. Its spirit could not be eradicated. So the heroes used the Crystal Stars which they had stolen from the demon, and they cast the evil beast into the depths of a vast maze and sealed the exit. From this, I gather that the Crystal Stars cannot distinguish good from evil. So if they're all united, they could either steal away or resurrect the demon. It seems who wields the Crystal Stars determines if they're used for evil or good. Hey, then isn't it possible that we shouldn't gather these Crystal Stars? Even if we do find them all, someone could just steal them all and revive that monster. Maybe we ought to just stomp the heck out of him and throw the pieces away. That's logical. That was my first thought, too, but further research suggests we can't do that. It's against the RPG rules. There's a slight possibility that the Thousand Year Door is weakening. It seems that the Crystal Stars hold the power to seal the beast for 1,000 years. So, once 1,000 years has passed, the power to keep the door sealed shut will fail. And unfortunately, this year may be the 1,000th year. Bad luck, huh? The fact that those goons won't want the stars now may be coincidence, but maybe not. In other words, we must be ready for the demon's return, even if the X-Knots fail. Whatever. Whoa, let's roll then. We gotta get the rest of those Crystal Stars. Where's the next one at? Huh. According to the map, it appears to be somewhere on Keel Hall Key. Keel Hall Key? Try saying that 10 times fast. I'm none too familiar with the place, but I've heard countless unsavory rumors. You know, the usual stuff. Vengeful spirits full of hatred, even curses, things like that. I'm sure the sea salt's down by the harbor no more. You should head there first. Alright, so first off, I don't think I actually went over this. If you, like, you know, read this trash can, you actually get a lot, you actually get, tattle logs from the old bosses. that you didn't previously get. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go upgrade our party members. So I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, so we are back. We ended up upgrading Vivian and Flurry here. And so they got a bunch of new moves. No, I do not want you coops. All right, so we're actually going to just take care of some general stuff. What we want to do here is go through into this corner, get a star piece there, and I believe you can jump up. Yep. Ah, jeez. Or not. I guess there's just a star piece there. All right. And so what we... Okay. Let me say something, and I'm going to try to keep it as spoiler-free as possible. Now, I know a lot of fans of you... I know a lot of you guys do actually know Paper Mario. And at this point in the game, traditionally, there is a quest we can take care of at the Trouble Center, which, of course, I'll go into greater detail about later. However, we will not be handling that side quest until later. We also have the option to upgrade our party members to a second level. However, once again, I'm not going to be handling that till the next post-chapter shenanigans, because there's so much going on, actually, in this chapter. Alright, let's see. I believe, what happens if we go... Oh, right. Okay, that's not really that important. Okay, so we got a shine sprite there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to meet you guys in the western part of town. Actually, I decided against it because we actually do have good reason to be at this part of town. What we want to do is go through into this house, and if we talk to Tasty, or I believe that's her name, or Zesty, I should say, we could actually, wait, I believe we actually have to get her to cook something, hold on, alright, yes, cook up our slow shroom, doodly doo, dee 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 doo 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 doo. And yes, she's a cook. She can actually cook up some of our stuff, make it way better, so we can, you know, get more. Whoa, there's a fire there. Ooh, fire. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm not entirely sure you'll like this, but go on, take it, Stompy. And we got Shroom Roast, which replenishes 15 HP and 5 FP. Okay. So, you know, what we can do is give her the cookbook thingy. Let's see. Well, shall I cook something? What the? I do have a cookbook thingy, don't I? Whatever. I'll handle that later. I'm sure you guys will correct me in the comments what I'm supposed to be doing. Graffiti Corner. Sometimes I think I'd better not speaking. Oh, I wish I was still a pig. Morbidly depressed Twilighter. Nice. Okay, so we are in the west part of town now. I believe what we want to do is go here. What's inside one of these? Wait. I think it is here. Let's see. Let's talk to this toad here. No. Let's talk to this toad here. Yeah, he's getting rich off internet options and all that fun jazz. And you know, funny enough, actually, one of my friends apparently had a friend that actually got, like, that actually made a killing, like, restocking. Where basically you just you purchase things for a really, really low price and you can actually resell them at a higher price. That's what a lot of people did with the PS3 when it launched. Anyway, so what we want to do here is jump out, is go through that little hole thingy, and we get a shine sprite. Now, I'm sure you guys are wondering, GrandPyromania, how are we going to get out? Well, this is what we do. There's actually a little thing here that we can tube through and go through this guy's dresser, which is kind of weird, actually, if you think about it, but, and I believe he actually has a different response, yet another, whatever, I thought he actually said something interesting. Oh, that's not fun at all, in the slightest. Okay, now, there is something else that we can do before we actually progress with the plot. It's in the sewers, so I will meet you guys there. Okay, so if you notice that we can actually go through this door thingamajigger. And so there are these spikes. Now, before this chap, before the end of chapter 4, I guess you could say, we couldn't actually get past those. Out. Oh, what? Okay. So now with Vivian's help, we can actually get past it. And whoa, that was a close one. Very too close. Whoa, that was even closer. Jeez. Wow, I am barely cutting it, aren't I? Okay. Aw, poor Vivian. And we get the Spike Shield badge, which of course allows us to now finally jump on evil peoples that have spikes on their heads. And that is actually incredibly useful. So I'm gonna go ahead and equip that, and I will meet you guys at the docks, because that's where we have to go next. Okay, so we're back at the docks. So Professor Frankly said we should investigate here and ask these little guys down here. What, Kill Hall Key? Oh, that place is absolutely awful, I've heard. Not long ago, ship after ship went there hunting treasure, but none have ever returned. I bet they met the bad end of the Pirate King's curse. Those guys are dumb. Pirate King. Interesting. Let's see what else. Kikihalki, you mean there's the island where the treasure hoard of Cortez, the Pirate King, is hidden? So, you want treasure, eh? But fine, keep an eye out or the Pirate's curse will get you. Let's see. Kikihalki? That's a cursed island! Don't get mixed up with that place for your own sake! Okay, let's see what this guy says. No matter how much I work, life never gets any easier for me, know what I mean? There's got to be some way to get to just go poof and get rich, you know? Poof! Okay, that's it. Oi! Yo! With the mustache! What's with the stink eye, eh? You got something to say? Right, then ask me anything. I'm like an encyclopedia. I am! I can answer anything. Oh, Keel Hall K. Listen, mate. Don't ask me about that place. I got no need for a curse from the Pirate King.
See that ship dock there? She belongs to Flavio, the merchant trader. He don't sail too often, though. Mostly he hangs at Podley's joint on the plaza.
Okay. And so, wow, this is a nice ship. That is a really, really nice ship. I think we should put... Maybe we can convince this Flavio dude to bring us to Kill Hall Key with that really, really nice ship. I mean, come on. That is expertly designed. So, okay. Let's see. Oh, there's Ouija. Hi, Ouija. I take it this really fruity dude is Flavio. And what do you want, huh?
Who, me? You ask about...
Oh, I am called Flavio. I am, how you say, a trader. The richest man in Rockport. Monetary wealth gives me freedom, yes, and freedom...
I can't even do my Spanish. I don't know. Apparently I could do a really good Spanish accent, but... And when I do, I sound exactly like, Zevran from Dragon Age Origins? I don't know. Let's see, I must know, what do I lack? Let's see... Probably thrills. Thrills, you say? Ah, I suppose everyone does need a thrill every now and again. There is nothing like the feeling of being alone on a mountain, shivering to death. What? Ah, no, foolish Flavio, not chills, you silly man. What I need are thrills. Wait, hold the horses. That is it! What? Let's see. Now that I'm thinking of it, I once heard of the treasure of Cortez, the Pirate King. Yes, this is the answer. Oh, such happiness for me. A hunt for pirate treasure. Why, that just shrieks of romance and thrills and emotion and even money. Do you not know the tale of the Pirate King's treasure hidden on Keel Hall Key? Ah, well, tales say that the Pirate King Cortez hid his hoard of pirate booty there. For years, treasure hunters and ruffians have gone there in search of the loot. But not a single one of them has ever returned. Oh, the horror makes my back tingle. People here whisper that the ghost of Cortez attacks all who seek his treasure. Eek. It's because of those very rumors that people no longer go to Keel Hall Key. But that will not stop Flavio. That treasure is there, yes? And I'm going to prove it. For I am Flavio, trader extraordinaire, millionaire, sailor of the seven seas. What is that you're saying? You also are looking for a treasure? Here in Rockport? Why, talk such craziness? There isn't anything like that in this dope armpit of a town. You cannot be believing each stupid rumor about treasure some street urchin spews out. No, 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 no! Now that, what madness comes from bursting from your mouth? Do you have a treasure map? Well, hand it over. Rather, I mean, show it me. You're having a joke on me. This map leads straight to Kill Hall Key. You swine, you mean to steal my treasure from out from under me, you awful, awful man. Well, now I'm confused. You're looking for a thing known as crystal stars.
Oh, yeah.
But now that I'm thinking, a star-shaped stone was said to be in Cortez's hoard. Perhaps I could sell it for a staggering amount of cash. Yes, that would be... Ah, stop such thoughts, Flavia. What you need is romance, thrills, and emotion. I cannot ignore what this business before me suggests. This must be a fate at work. Flavia will go with you to Keel Hall Key. Of course, the crystal star is yours, yes, but the rest of the treasure is mine. Huh? You must repeat that. Flavio's ears are plugged. You have no ship? Ha! You unfortunate, foolish man! Do you not know who I am? I will have a ship ready in no time, and it will be massive and glorious! Splendid, splendid, splendid. Let us begin preparations immediately, shall we? I will volunteer myself as our interpreter leader, and you will be the captain. Ah, danger and adventure tickle my nostrils. Come to the harbor right away. Okay, so we've made... Mario just looked pissed for a second there. Okay. Alright, so we made arrangements to go to Keel Hall Key, so in the next episode, we're gonna go tackle that. So, this is GrandPyromania, signing out. See you guys next time.